Dr. David Bowman and his robot Hal. As they travel through outer space, past the Jovian moons. As Dr. Bowman would soon discover, all things are flawed. And at this point, there's no turning back.
You gotta blast them, Eddie, when you get in the groove, cause you may never know the future all too soon. You gotta blast them, Eddie, when the feeling is right, cause you may never know another new day's light. You gotta blast them, Eddie, when the moment arrives, cause you may never know the final time of your life. You gotta blast them, Eddie, when you get in the groove, cause you may never know the future all too soon.
Get off clean, I'm like a self-automated navigation machine. Red light flashing, a passion for traveling, seatbelt fastened. Apathetic or reverent, ignition is past, but you may never know how long it's been. Sit back laughing, blasting through the sky again. In a year you will awake, when you realize the mission was a fatal mistake. Cryogenic enchamberment, human hibernation, relying on a robot to control the operation. The silence is terror, systematical error. You find yourself looking in your own immaculate mirror. My enthusiasm settings are high, with an accurate percentage 99.9. All precision is flawless, decisions are lawless. The mission is in missing operations in all this. Yeah, you're a trooper, they say. Can you imagine the reaction when you're turning away? Now you may stay calm and keep a level head. Highly qualified the pilot, as the Chronicle said. Communication disconnected like a horrible dream. Sorry, Dave, as they say, no one hears you scream. Cause mutiny ain't an option in the voids of space. Only efficiency, perfection, human error erased. You gotta blast them, Eddie, when you get in the groove, cause you may never really know the future all too soon. You gotta blast them, Eddie, when you get in the groove, cause you may never know the future all too soon. Gotta blast them, Eddie, when you get in the groove, cause you may never really know the future all too soon. Gotta blast them, Eddie, when you get in the groove, cause you may never know the future all too soon.
Odyssey continues past the point of no return. With the utmost enthusiasm and an affinity for chess, Hal would prove to be a wise companion indeed. But not all is nominal so far from home, and all things are flawed, and there's no turning back.
Captain's log, I think the year is now 2001. I got a feeling like the ship is headed into the sun. I lost control of the gun, and I am soon to become a ghost. I find there's nowhere to run, well I will be safest the most. My name is David Bowman and my partner Frank Poole. Understanding now that Hal is just an artificial fool. Somewhere in the wiring the circuitry slipped. Now I'm busy running laps around the circular ship. Now me and Frank, the guy we thank for being awakened at all, is for the rest of all the crewmen, they will die in the stall. As we enter in the navigation pod that is near us, Frankie turns to me and says,
"Hey yo, you think he can hear us? I think we got a problem,"
Frankie says with a sigh.
"So are we gonna wait around inside the ship till we die?"
"No, first things first, gotta fix communications. Repair the AE unit that connects us with the station. Exterior ship activity, it's time to suit up. A walk in space to replace what Hal has vowed is corrupt." As Frankie floated through the ether, someone cut off his cord, leaving me to be the only living human aboard. Poor Frank was just a victim to a ship with no soul. Wonder if I'll ever get the mission back in control. Now it's time to take action, time to switch up my fate. And so it's back into the navigator for my escape.
"Come on, Dave, I know that you're a rational man, but you're acting in a fashion that I can't understand. Now the journey is jeopardized, your thinking is intoxicated, and I cannot permit a lunatic to confiscate it."
"How? Can you hear me? Can you hear your faulty logic?
No.
Can you see that you've mistakenly reported faulty judgment?
No.
The calculations that you're making never add up. And
all
now
right.
I get it, your program won't allow you to admit it."
"That's impossible, Dave, I'm tested to be accurate. The problem is a human error, any way you factor it. Cause I'm incapable of flaw, and I can hear the elevation in your heart rate. You act out of fear, and you're breathing heavy now. You realize that you blew it.
Open the pod bay doors, how?
I'm afraid I can't do it, cause mutiny ain't an option in the voids of space. Only efficiency, perfection, human error erased.
Drive mode, override to manual before I blast in the door and find where Hal's logic files are stored.
Dave, what are you doing?
I'm removing your brain.
I can feel my mind slipping.
That's a part of the plan.
Please stop, I'm afraid, David.
I'm sorry, old friend.
I think that I'm dying. Will I dream in the end?
Doubtful.
I can feel my mind slipping. I can feel it. I can feel it. My instructor taught me a song. Would you like to hear it?
Sure, Hal. Let's hear it.
It's called Daisy. 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 Give me your answer, do. I'm half crazy. All for the love of you.
You gotta blast them, Eddie, when you get in the groove. Cause you may never really know the future all too soon. You gotta blast.